I'm Dr. Marwa Kaisey. I'm a board certified neurologist, and today I'm going to talk to you about the single worst thing you can do for your brain. Now, unless you're a professional boxer or playing the NFL, that one thing that most of us can do that will have the worst effect on our brain is smoking. Okay, smoking can cause all sorts of damage to the brain. It can cause strokes or silent mini strokes that those in themselves can lead to seizures and dementia in the long run. So smoking is hugely, hugely bad for our brain. I'm also an MS specialist, multiple sclerosis, so I want to talk today specifically about how smoking can affect people with MS. And when I diagnose somebody new with MS, you know, we have a conversation about lifestyle, things they can do to make their MS better. And one question I get a lot is, Dr. Kaisey, what should I not be doing? What am I doing that's actually making this worse? And there's really only one answer, and that is picking up smoking. Thankfully, practicing here in LA, not a lot of people smoke, so most of them will just laugh like, haha, I never intended to smoke anyway. But for the 11% of people with MS, it is very important to quit smoking. And we know that about 2/3 of them are interested in quitting smoking. At least that's what they tell the people conducting these surveys, whether it's totally accurate or not. But you can eat the gluten, you can eat the dairy, you can do all those things. Just please do not smoke. And we're going to talk a little bit about what smoking does in MS. So it does everything from increasing somebody's risk of getting MS in the first place. Even secondhand smoke has been shown to increase somebody's risk of developing MS, all the way through increasing risk of new and active lesions, increasing risk of switching from the relapsing remitting type of MS to the progressive type, which is much harder to treat these days at least. And then once somebody's in the progressive phase, making the progression faster. So from pre-MS all the way to progressive chronic MS, smoking harms the brain in a way that makes the MS itself worse. And there have been a lot of different studies to show that. I have my notes here. I can tell you that smoking also delays the diagnosis in people with MS. Now, delayed a diagnosis is something that's very difficult to measure, but one particular study that I'll give you guys the details for in the notes here is showed that people who smoke and then get diagnosed with MS have more MS morbidity at the time of diagnosis. That means they've been acquiring more damage, they've had potentially more symptoms before anyone ever is able to diagnose them. And part of that is that smoking affects the brain in different ways, and it may cause non-MS type lesions that may cause symptoms that aren't related to MS that really muddy the picture when somebody also has MS brain lesions and MS symptoms and we're trying to diagnose that. So I'm not surprised to read the findings of the study, which is that by the time they're diagnosed, smokers with MS just have a more have had the MS for longer. They've had more damage due to the MS by the time that they get their final diagnosis. As we mentioned, it increases risk of progressing to secondary progressive MS from the relapsing remitting form. And again, secondary progressive MS is more difficult to treat at this point. We don't have any great treatments for it. And it increases this risk in one study by 5% a year. 5% a year, that's a big number, given that MS is something people live with for decades usually. And people reached progressive type of MS a full 8 years earlier if they smoked compared to their non-smoking counterparts. Again, once you start on this progressive path, it tends to keep going, it tends to keep progressing. So the more we can delay somebody reaching that stage, the better. And so reaching it 8 years earlier is a big deal and something that we would like to avoid. Smoking also not only increases lesions in people with MS, it makes their brains shrink faster. That's as bad as it sounds. We definitely don't want our brains shrinking any faster than they need to. Aging makes our brains shrink. That's just natural and unavoidable. MS makes the brain shrink a little faster, especially undertreated MS. And then smoking is kind of a third whammy on top of those first two that accelerates brain shrinkage. Again, not a good thing. But the good news is that some of these studies found that it makes a difference whether somebody quits smoking. So a couple of studies didn't find a big difference between people who had ever smoked, meaning current or former smokers, and people who never smoked. But several studies did find that if people quit smoking, that really helped to turn things around. And there's been similar literature on this and things like lung cancer risk, right? If you stop smoking, after about 10 to 15 years, your risk of cancer goes down to a non-smoker level. And one study in Brain from 2013 found that getting to an EDSS of 6, now this is a kind of a scale we haven't talked about yet, I'm not a huge fan of it, but it is the scale in MS to measure how somebody's doing. It is heavily based on walking. And 6, it goes from 0 to 10. 6 is like the halfway point where somebody starts needing to use a cane to walk. So they measured how long it took people to get to that 6 mark, which is a big landmark on this scale. And your risk if you were a current smoker was 50% higher than someone with MS who'd never smoked of getting to that landmark. Whereas your risk if you had previously smoked and then quit was only 30% higher than people who'd never smoked. So still an elevated risk compared to never smokers, but definitely less than people who were current active smokers. So that's a big reason to quit for sure, in addition to maybe helping stop further damage due to smoking. So how to quit, you know, when I have this conversation with my patients, and I always ask my new patients, especially if I'm meeting them for the first time, if they smoke. They've heard it from doctors before. I am not the first person, I am probably not the 10th person even, to tell them that smoking is bad for their body, and they've heard about the cancer risk, and they've heard about the heart attack risk. They may have even heard about the stroke risk, but very, very few of them, even if they've had MS for a while, have heard about the direct risk of smoking to making their MS worse. And for a lot of them, that's the light bulb moment. That's what they need to say, well, okay, I really now want to quit. So for those who now have the motivation to want to quit, how do you do that? One method is cold turkey. You could just stop. If you're able to do that and do it successfully, more power to you. That's wonderful. It's rare because nicotine in cigarettes is highly addictive. So most of us, our bodies and our brains, need something to help us wean off of that a little more gently than just going cold turkey, which doesn't tend to work very well. The other two things you can try are medications. So there's a lot of different meds, and then there's things like gum patches that help too, that give you kind of a smaller, either give you a smaller dose of nicotine, like the gum and patches to help wean you off over time, or just help you to wean off by taking a medication every day, like a pill specifically. So those can be really helpful strategies. Even they work even better if we combine them with a therapy, like talk therapy designed to help somebody quit an addiction like nicotine. And so talk to your, really the primary care doctor is a great resource for this. And a lot of places like our hospital have a pharmacist that can help guide people through the smoking cessation program as well as therapy. So there's a lot of different resources out there to help you quit if you are so motivated, which I really hope you are after hearing what smoking can due to the brains of people with MS. How does it do this? Sometimes I'm asked this by people who are, for example, vaping, and they're wondering if I'm vaping the nicotine, is it the same as smoking a cigarette? There's not a huge amount of data on this, a huge amount of rigorous study of how exactly smoking affects the brain. There's a few different theories. Is that one, the nicotine itself has been found in the spinal fluid of people with MS. What does that mean? That means that one, it's the nicotine specifically, it's not necessarily all the toxins in the cigarette, although those can't be good for the brain either. But now we have evidence that the nicotine has gone from your blood across the blood-brain barrier and is now in the fluid that's bathing your brain and spinal cord. Not good. That's pretty scary. And that's a significant finding in a way that it can be affecting it, because the nicotine could be directly toxic to the cells in the brain and in the spinal cord. Cigarettes also can weaken the blood-brain barrier, which is the brain and the spinal cord's defense against some of the bad stuff that's in our blood. Specifically, it sometimes can help protect people with MS from their overactive immune system and those immune cells coming from the blood into the brain and attacking the brain, which is really the crux of what causes MS. So it can be directly damaging to the brain, and it can be indirectly damaging by weakening our brain and spinal cord's defenses against some of the bad immune cells that are floating around in the blood. So there's definitely a few theories on why it may be damaging the brain in people with MS. They're probably both a little bit correct. Maybe there's other things that are going on. I don't think there's one answer, but there's likely several different ways that the damage is happening. And do people with MS smoke more than the general population? There's no data to really support this, but we do know that smoking itself is heavily associated with some mental health conditions. Schizophrenia is the biggest one. So many people with schizophrenia smoke because it can help their symptoms. But depression and anxiety are others. And we know that depression and anxiety are very common symptoms of people living with MS. And so there definitely may be an increased risk to want to smoke if you have MS, maybe a little bit indirectly through some of the mood issues that MS can cause. So there you have it. Smoking is really bad for all of our brains. It's especially bad for the brains of people living with MS. It can affect everything from delaying their diagnosis to them having more lesions to getting to progressive MS and needing an assistive device to walk faster. It can also cause shrinkage of the brain to be more rapid. So all of those things are a great reason to want to quit smoking. If you do want to quit, there are tons of resources out there. Nothing really specific to people with MS. Any of the resources for quitting smoking work well too. And you know, MS may predispose somebody to wanting to smoke a little bit through causing depression and anxiety, which are risk factors for smoking. So it may not be the easiest thing to quit, but I hope this video has given you the motivation that you need to start thinking about it.